Messina the mecca of African migrants?
Messina, it is a port of entry. There are people from Ghana, there are people from Nigeria, Ethiopian, Somalia, Malawian, people from Mozambique, people from Zimbabwe. It is where they enter our country.
Neighboring Zimbabwe, Beitbridge is Africa's busiest border crossing, both legally and illegally. Iru traveled with 46 other Ethiopians for 3 months through 6 countries to reach South Africa. They often traveled by foot and ate at refugee camps along the way.
It was, however, only when they reached South Africa that their problems began. They were kidnapped at the door of Home Affairs by alleged human traffickers.
And they transported them to Toyandu, where they kept them in 2 houses. The doors were kept closed and also the windows, and they were not able to go outside.
We wanted to learn more about the difficult journey, so we visited the border.
These 2 Zimbabwean farmers were lingering near the border fence.
I'm looking for my cattle here in South Africa. They used to come 3 times a week.
It's not difficult. They just cross each and every time. Night, day, they cross.
Now I'm in Zimbabwe. Take a few steps forward and I'm in South Africa. I didn't have to present my passport, nor did I have to jump over a barbed wire fence. For this gate has been left open for the last 4 months.
The border is controlled by an army base less than 100 meters away. Explained why it was difficult to secure the border.
It's not because we are trying them. What I don't know how when are they going to sort this thing out for us? Lot of them are inside here. So now when they come in here, we will feel also. Cattle, donkeys, you come in to fetch our cattle. You see, it's difficult. You understand? It's difficult to protect even this line. We've got even our own farmers that are here. Then it's a challenge with them. Because they also, now when you lock this, they start to complain. Because some of them, they own their own water pumps inside them. It's a challenge.
The soldiers said this is one of multiple open gates into South Africa, a seemingly deliberate loophole for hopeful asylum seekers.
South Africa is a small haven for them where they can live a better life than any other place.
Thank you. muck, but ask your radio, if you put your radio off, right, and you listen to what's going on here, then you realize, well, all the singing and the people around the place that's loading their trucks, etc.
Yes.
That's such a big noise. And you should see, all the dirt that's left after they leave. Lovely here, because there was nobody here that worried us.
Yeah.
Because we could go out of the gate, walk around here, and come back again, and nobody worried about
and
us.
And now you can't even put your feet outside this walls.
Sometimes you can't even get inside the gate. You know, about the 3 weeks ago, there was 7 trucks parked there, one in the middle of the road, and it was pulling forward, and I actually tried to get in the gate, and he pushed the hooter. He told me to move away.
Because he wanted to offload his trucks.
Because he wanted to offload his trucks.
So first, the main problem here is the trucks offloading everything.
The noise is unbelievable.
And from, you say, about 5 years ago this started happening.
Well, it's more or less between four and five years.
Because it's when what do they call them, the Pakistanis arrived, eh? And they took this, they hired this place, or they bought it, I'm not sure.
All the houses that these Pakistanis are buying up here, it's Pakistanis, Bangladeshis, all the streets that are buying all the houses up.
Yes, it's incredible. You know, I think the back street here, just about all of those houses have now been bought up by them.
And then they make warehouses and everything.
Yes, exactly. They do. It's terrible. And you know, this guy at the back, it's now a new shop that's opened 2 weeks ago. And he makes so much noise that I can't even have my quiet time in the morning anymore.
And it goes on
it
until
goes
late
on
at
until
night.
Late at night.
It's starting now.
And what's the time now? It's almost about 5:30 now. And now the noise is starting.
He's been playing music the whole day.
Right,
it's every day now. It's every single day, from about 6 o'clock, just after 6 o'clock, he starts with this throbbing music, and the Indian music, day through, every single day.
And as I believe that the trucks aren't allowed to come in.
Yes, it's incredible. You know, I think the back street here, just about all of those houses have now been bought up by them.
And then they make warehouses and everything.
Yes, exactly, they do. It's terrible. And you know, this guy at the back, it's now a new shop that's opened 2 weeks ago. And he makes so much noise that I can't even have my quiet time in the morning anymore.
Into the back streets of Messina, there's a bylaw prohibiting 3.5 ton trucks coming
in. Not in Messina.
Okay, what other problem have you been having in this area here?
People. I'm not only saying it's the Zimbabweans and the other ones, they're South Africans, some of them as well. They use our pavements for toilets. I actually, some mornings, I have to go out, dig a hole, scratch the rubbish in the hole and cover it up. And they urinate right through our fencing into our gardens. I had to tell another guy the other day, for heaven's sake, would you like it if I come and do this in your front yard? And he apologized, but he just went to the next tree and he did it there. They use our pavements for toilets. It is shocking. And the rubbish, they come and they load their trucks and their, what do they call them, trailers?
Their horses. Their horse trailers.
Well, with the Zimbabweans, it's just an ordinary trailer. And they take some of the stuff out of the boxes, put them on the trailer, then they take those boxes and throw them there, throw the porridge, the pieces of pop like this, they just throw it through our fences, and we have to clean it up the next morning. Now, I'm fed up with this. I'm totally fed up with this.
trokke hier in die dorp. Hulle het gesê dat die trokke nie bo 3.5 ton mag hier in die dorp kom nie. En julle weer af van hè.
Ja.
Is dit hierdie speedkop sal vir julle enige iets gevra daarom? Het hulle al julle boetes gegee of het hulle al aangemaan dat julle nie in die dorp in moet kom nie?
Ek het nog nie speedkop gekry
nie. Is dit jy nog nie speedkop gekry nie? Ek is nou by jou. Ok, maar en jy weet, hulle sê, volgens die bylaws van die dorp, maar gaan geen trok bo 3.5 ton in die dorp kom
nie. Ek sien die bordjes, ja.
Maar toch, kom stop julle hier so en hulle doen niks nie. Hulle het julle nog een keer kom pla
nie. Niks
nie. Ons praat vandag bietjie hierso met Annelien Barke van Goeie Rus Ouetehuis. In die afgelope paar jaar het die dinge by die ouetehuis vreeslik agteruit gegaan en ons het besluit dat ons se kant af 'n bietjie wil kom investigations soos die Engelsman sal instel oor wat hierso aangaan. En soos ons kan sien is dit vreeslik problematies alles wat hierso in hierdie agterstrate aangaan om die ouetehuis. So uit die diepste van ons hart uit wil ons na die ouetehuis toe kom en kom kyk wat ons vir hulle kan doen. Tannie Lien, baie dankie dat Tannie met ons kom gesels hierso vandag. Kan Tannie bietjie vir ons vertel wat in die straat hierso om Tannie hulle aangaan? Wat se gruwe het Tannie hulle wat die mense nie na luister nie?
Die veiligheid, op die oomblik is dit effens skoon, maar die merendeel kom lê hulle hier op die gras, gooi soos jy sien daar, die bokse oor, lê daar op en saap, jy kan maar met hulle praat, dan vloek hulle ons.
Vloek hulle vir Tannie hulle?
Vloek ons. En jy weet ek wat nou ongelukkig partij van die tale verstaan, weet precies wat hulle vir my sê. En dit help nie om in die municipaliteit daar oor te praat nie, hulle doen niks, dan bel ek maar beeldwag. Hulle kom jaag hulle weg, 10 minute later is hulle terug.
Dan is hulle terug. Dan
is hulle terug. Dit gaan daar skoop ons, maar jy sien wat dit is vir jou woord. Dit is van wat oos is hier op. Ek het nie eens meer een wekker nodig om my wakker te maak. Die muziek is net oorkant.
Vir die hele dag.
Of jy TV wil kyk of radio wil luister, moet jy jou deure alles van die buitenkant af toemaak, van binnenkant af toemaak, in een hokkie sit, dat jy daarom vir jouself iets kan hoor.
En vir Tannie hulle is hierdie onaanvaarbaar. Almal in Messina betaal erfbelasting. Tannie hulle is die senior citizens, en ek verwag dat van die municipaliteitse kant af, dat hulle bietjie sal onderzoek instel hierso, en dat hulle na die griepe van die ou mense sal luister. Jy weet, as baie van die mense in die nedersettings in die townships praat, dan luister die mense, maar die minderheid hierso in Messina, as ons praat, dit word op doewe ore gesê.
Doewe ore. Nou, die municipaliteit het gesê, geen veilig vervoer het vertel as het nie in zwart zakke is. Maar ek hoop nie vir jullie Pakistanis en zwart mense te sê nie. Ek bly 47 jaar in Messina.
47 jaar?
En dit is die eerste keer in my leven, die naaste 3 jaar, wat ek Messina gekeer is, soos nie.
En ons kan nou sê, hierso kom een groot interlink trok nou ingerui hierso. Volgens die bywete van die dorp sê dit dat daar geen trok bo 3.5 ton in Messina mag inkom nie. Maar soos ons nou kan sien, word die wette nie toegepas in Messina nie. En dis waarom ons hierdie video maak, is so dat julle, die kijkers, kan sien wat in Messina aangaan.
En die parkeer hier, en
stepe
tot af onder op
jou. Tot onder op jou. Ons is self op hierdie DVD, soos julle sal sien, you can see that that we have various footage about what is currently happening in Messina. The trucks that are standing where they are standing, every second house in Messina is being bought by a Pakistani, Bangladeshi, and these guys are doing just what they want. Nothing is being done for the town people here. We have been writing letters, we have been asking, what is happening here? Why is the people buying every house, developing it into a storeroom or a shop? It's problematic, and we are calling on each one to inquire about what is happening here. And Tanilin, can you please tell us what else is on your heart?
On my heart is really the problem that whenever a doctor or a nurse or whatever wants to come and visit you, there's no parking space for them.
No parking space for any doctors?
No, nothing. Nothing whatsoever. You've got to help them to come into the big gate, if there's somebody to open it for them with a remote, because the doctors are without remotes, without keys. They can't come in. Somebody must open for them. Therefore, if they stop here, there's no way where they can park here to come in. It's impossible.
And let's say you want to go, you know, you want to go to the shops here, buy yourself some groceries. What is the process that you must follow to do that?
That is a difficult question, because really you've got to hide your money away or your card or whatever, and you're too scared to walk out of this gate to go and do some shopping. The only way I can do it, ask my garden boy, here's a little letter for you, go and buy me this or go and buy me that. I am not safe to go out of this gate, go and buy myself anything.
What capacity do you have here at the old age home? What is your job here?
At the moment, I'm the head of the, what do they call it here? The Queerus Gouwe Circle. It's a community that we've had here for the people. We have every Tuesday we have church here. Every Wednesday, every second Wednesday we have a meeting. Then we get all the complaints from the people, and we've got to take that complaints over to either Henny Erbier, you know, he's the solicitor here, or either to the pastor Dominic Anton King. Sometimes we get results, sometimes we don't get even an answer.
Is it so at this stage you are fed up with what is happening here?
I am.
As we can see here, they are busy building a new shop just here at the back. They are revamping the shop, and if we look down here, we can see there is just Zimbabwe cars, it is shops, it is warehouses that is starting up here. And just down the street here, we can see that there is a church that has been broken down, and they want to build a new Pakistani, Bangladeshi, let's say it, foreign mall. So things in Messina is going downhill with a big speed. And we have been asking the mayor to do something about this. We have been asking, for nothing has been happening here. So now, like I said, we are calling on to the public, the broader public, South Africa. We are calling upon the international public to help us regarding this situation. As you can see, Tanilin has been staying here for 47 years. And the last 5 to 7 years, things has been going very difficult here. It's going down the drain. And just here behind us is an open drain. Tanilin, can you tell us about the open drain that is here just next to your house?
It's an open drain with no lid upon it. When the drain is full and there's no sewage running through, they've got to come and collect with a truck. Then that drain, all the refuse is running down this road here. Coming out of that hole, or either from out in the middle of the street, there's a manhole where it's also bubbling out. And that is running here. We've got to phone the municipality and ask them, please send somebody to come and see if they can't stop this.
And are the municipality doing it at the moment?
In about 3 to 4 hours time.
In about 3 to 4 hours. Yeah. And is there times that they don't pitch up?
As far as I know, while Lionel was here, it was still all right. I could phone him and he'd say, all right, I'll send somebody for you. But when it's a black person from the municipality, sorry to say that, you've got to wait.
You've got to wait?
Yeah.
And have you? What is the time frame that you have to wait?
There you are, 3, 4, up to 5 hours. I've waited 2 days already.
2 days for the sewage running down the street here, right in front of your house.
My house, the next house, all the
all the houses down the street here. How many residents is residing here at the old age house?
We've got 26 houses and there's 33 residents.
33 residents.
But there's something that's bothering me. As far as I know, and as far as I can remember, there was always a sign nearby an old age home for silence, no parking or something like that. There's nothing like that here.
No parking and silence, nothing. And around you, this is the hot spot for development in Messina. As you're going to see on the DVD, or you already saw, things in Messina, it's not well. And if we don't get help very soon, Messina is on its way to becoming the capital of...
Yes. We've got this road running down to the primary school.
and you've got cars running up and down for hours in the morning and in the afternoon. And still, they just carry on, put everything what they want on the road and they don't pick it up, and it's like that. When they send that lady to pick up all the dirt, put it in a backpack, and they put it, they pick it up with a wire, and if they don't pick it up decently, they just throw it on the sidewalk. And I've got to pay my garden boy to clean it up, which I think is very, very unreal to think that you've got to pay for people from another country because it's most Bosnian children and Pakistani. And if there are the Pakistani stories and things, they should see that all their rubbish is being picked up.
It's being picked up, I agree 100% with you. Soos wat julle kan sien, is hierso 'n grinder reg agter ons wat hulle besig is om die winkel mee op te gradeer. Van die lint tot watse tyd in die aande is hierdie geraas aan die gang hierso?
Wat oor 10:30, kyk jy 10:40, dan kan jy nog net self en sit ek nog in die sitkamer, want daar is my selfkamer, hier waar dit gegrind word. Ek kan nie
so moeilik gesê. En met die gebouery van die nuwe winkels en alles maak die mense net so baie geraas.
Net so geraas. En dan lê al die rommel wat hulle van die stene en semente goed op die sypaadjies gooi, lê vir weke daar.
Jo, ek het gesien hierso teen die kant hierso is daar al bakstene wat al daar lê vir die afgelope 3 jaar.
Dis reg.
En daar's niks van die munisipaliteit se kant af wat gedoen word daaraan. Die mense vra, hoekom betaal ons eiendomsbelasting? Vir ons word daar minimale dienste gelewer. Meeste van die inwoners van Messina besluit om hulle self, hulle kry buitekontrakteurs of hulle kry tuindienste om hulle rommel weg te ry.
Ja, dit is wat ons doen. Ons doen dit, ons betaal vir tuindienste.
Ons sal graag wil weet, wat is 'n persentasie van die belastingbetalers bly binne in Messina? En hoeveel persent van die belastingbetalers bly in die informele nedersetting? Dit is 'n baie goeie vraag en ons gaan kyk of ons kan inligting daaroor kry, want in Messina word daar minimale dienste gelewer. Volgens 'n bron by die munisipaliteit gaan dit 234 miljoen rand kos om ons paaie in 'n goeie werkende kondisie te kry.
Vertel net vir my, hierdie Pakistanies wat so bou en invoer en weer uitvoer, betaal hulle belasting?
Dis 'n baie goeie vraag daai tannie, en ek dink vir die publiek, hulle behoort dit ook te weet. Volgens bronne by verskeie banke is vir ons al ingelig dat 6 of 7 van hierdie Pakistani, kom ons sê Somaliese winkels, uitheemse winkels, gaan na die bank toe, hulle betaal 6, 7 miljoen rand in 'n rekening in, dit gaan direk na die verskaffer se rekening toe, die Interlink trok kom na die winkel toe, hulle kom met hulle forklifts, hulle vat al die goeders na die 6 of 7 winkels toe, en daar word geen belasting betaal nie. Ons vra nou vir julle, SARS, wat word hieraan gedoen? Kan julle vir ons vertel, waarheen gaan al die belasting wat hierso betaal word? Is daar enige belasting wat betaal word?
Want die trokke hier voor die deur stil hou, en hulle weet wat ek, moet hy om aansluiting, ten minste 20 minute moet hy aan die gang bly. Daai rook en fumes kom alles in ons huise in, en dit is vir ons 'n gesondheidsrisiko.
Thank you. Thank you.